Well, welcome to my fish room. My name is Tom. I'm with TM Aquatics. That's the name of my YouTube channel. I've been in the hobby, in and out of the hobby really, for about 40 years, and started out as a pretty young kid in the hobby. Dad used to keep some fish tanks back in the day, a bunch of those old metal frame fish tanks. We had a bunch of 5 gallon tanks and some 10 gallon tanks. And then one day he brought home a 30 gallon tank, and back then that thing seemed pretty massive, and kept some saltwater fish in there, and eventually we changed it over to African cichlids. We got into guppies and started breeding a bunch of different guppies back in the day, and from then on I was pretty much hooked on the hobby. Like I said, I've been in and out a little bit as the family grew, had to give up the hobby a couple times to focus a little bit more on the kids, but now we're empty nesters and got back into the hobby a few years ago. Quite a bit more than I had in the past. So have a little fish room back here. I've got, I think, 22 tanks right now up and running at TM Aquatics, focusing mainly on plecos. And although I do keep some other fish in my collection, like these red spotted severums, I have some angelfish, some corydoras, and some other fish, some red coral pencil fish, and I enjoy keeping them, but my primary focus right now is on the plecos. I keep some of the smaller species of plecos. I really don't have any big tanks in my fish room. This tank here is 120 gallons. That's the biggest tank I have, and then I do have some 75s. A bunch of 40 breeders, 55, and a couple of 75-gallon tanks. I like the high pancisterus and the picoltias. Those are my favorite types of plecos. I currently have a group of zebra plecos, some L134 leopard frog plecos that have been spawning for me pretty good this past year. Really enjoy the plecos, and you know, the downside, you don't really see them a lot. So if you want fish to come up and greet you at the glass and say hi and you know, show themselves, plecos aren't really the type of fish you want to be keeping. They're expensive, they're a beautiful fish, but you don't see them a lot. With that being said, my focus right now on my fish room is to spawn different types of plecos. I really enjoy it. I don't consider myself an expert. I'm simply a hobbyist, just like you would be. But I do try to associate with those that have kept plecos for quite a while. Learn stuff every day. And like I said, I really enjoy it. Like I said, I've always been into the hobby. And about 5-6 years ago, I was keeping high-tech planted tanks. I was keeping discus. In fact, I had discus in this tank here, and the bottom seal broke, and I had to rehome all the discus. And when that happened, it hit me pretty hard because it was a lot of money and a lot of time spent invested into those fish. And took a little bit of a break back then. I used to have a different name on my YouTube channel, and took about a 3-year break from YouTube to try and refocus, and got back into the hobby and picked up these red severums. I'm over here like dripping sweat, and like, my God, I feel like I'm being interrogated.
Can you tell us more about these red severums?
Yeah, I can tell you more about these
like
red
severums. Where they're from and...
Oh, I don't know that. They're from South America, I think. I'm not a cichlid guy. So.
Well, what the temperature, what you keep them at, and how you maintenance this tank.
Yeah, okay. So this tank here, this is my red severums, and I mentioned that I had discus and had to get rid of all my discus, and I didn't reseal the tank. I actually sold that tank and bought a new tank to fit the stand. And when I set this tank back up, I was kind of leaning towards discus, but after what I experienced, I didn't really know that I could do that. And I went to an LFS and they had these red spotted severums, and they had them for like 3 for $30, and they were about the size of a quarter or a nickel. They were pretty small. So I didn't really know what I wanted to put in this tank. I just know that I wanted something that gets kind of large. So I picked up 6 of them, and these fish that were only going to be a temporary fish in this tank have now been here for 2.5 years. They've now grown to about 8 to 9 inches from the nose to the ends of their little streamers on their tails. And I don't name my fish, but these are as close to a wet pet that I've ever had. And I will probably keep them around for quite a while. The tank itself, it's 120 gallon. It's a 5-foot tank, so it's 60 inches long. It's filtered by a sump system. The sump is kind of a homemade sump system. It's not a manufactured sump. We had an LFS nearby go out of business, and I went down there and they were clearing everything out. Actually, the owner had passed away, so they were liquidating all the assets from the store so the creditors could get some money and whatnot. In here with the Severums, they do have some friends. Because I am a Pleco guy, there's a few different Plecos in here. There's an L124 Orange Flame Para. There is a Gold Nugget in here. There's a L114 Cactus Pleco. And then there's an L14 Scobian Sistrus, or also known as the Sunshine Pleco. A few Clown Loaches, a few Corydoras, but out of all my tanks, this is probably my favorite. And I don't care if these fish breed or not, they've got a place here as long as they want. So you can find me on YouTube. My channel is TM Aquatics. I am on Instagram, I'm on Facebook, but I do use an alias name on Facebook. But Instagram, it's TM Aquatics as well. And I usually post those credentials at the end of my videos on YouTube. But be sure to stop by TM Aquatics on YouTube. I'd greatly appreciate it if you did.
Thanks, Tom.
Thank you. That was so awkward, man.